Hello friends, this video on body movements part 5 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So let us start with fibrous joints, which are also called as fixed joints. The name itself says that they are fixed because they are immovable. So that means these joints do not really result in any kind of movement. They do not allow movement. So that's one thing. So this proves that it is not necessary that wherever you have a joint, there has to be a movement. Because if that type, the type of joint which is present there is a fixed joint, there will be no movement. So this type of joint is found in cranium, upper jaw. So cranium is part of the skull. So inside our skull also we have lot of joints, lot of bones are like connected to each other, but those joints do not allow movement. That is why if you look at our skull, the skull doesn't have the flexibility to move. It is like rough and tough, it cannot bend or rotate. You talk about upper jaw, try opening your mouth. What happens? It is not that both your jaws open. It is only the lower jaw that is movable. Now try to keep your lower jaw fixed and try to move the upper jaw. Can you move it? You can't. So only the lower jaw is movable, but the upper jaw also has joints because the bones are connected there also, but they are all fixed joints. So they do not allow any kind of movement. So the joint between the upper jaw and parts of the skull, they are all fixed. So these are examples of fixed joints. Now these type of fixed joints, they do not have a joint cavity. That means in this case, the bones are connected by a layer of fibrous tissue. Like for example, the elbow joint, it is movable. Why? Because at this joint, you have some space within the joint which is filled with some fluid, and that space allows the movement. But in case of fixed joint, which is present in the upper jaw or in the skull, what happens is, let's say this is one bone and this is another bone. So these two bones are joined in such a way that the joint doesn't have any cavity. So there is no fixed space between, open space between the joints. They are united and there is a tissue present here. So it's like very hard. Now when the point of contact is so hard, so obviously there would be no flexibility and there would be no movement. So in case of fixed joint, there is no joint cavity. That means at the points where the bones are joined, there you do not have any empty space or there is no cavity. The next type of joint is the cartilaginous joint. So in these joints, limited movements are allowed. So movements are allowed, but only limited. It is not that you can move any way you want. So here bones are joined by cartilages. That is why the name is cartilaginous joints. So let me give you an example. So the best example that you can think of here is in the vertebral column, we have cartilaginous joint. That is why you would have seen that vertebral column, where is it present? In our back. So because of the presence of this, we can stand. So this is the vertebral column. Now what happens is, in vertebral column we have these type of joints, that is why we are able to bend our back, but then to a limited extent. It is not that we can completely rotate with the help of our back. So we can just bend it to some extent. So these are examples of limited movements where you can move but you cannot move it very freely. So here you have cavity, but that cavity is like very small cavity, not enough cavity. The third type is synovial joints, where considerable movements are allowed. Now why considerable movement is allowed? That's because here the cavity is filled with a fluid. So this fluid filled cavity allows movement, and because of that these joints allow free movements. So fluid filled synovial cavity between the two bones. So here when you have, let's say, one bone, you have another bone like this, and in between you have the synovial cavity which is filled with the fluid. So because of this, the two bones can actually slip over the fluid filled cavity and they can cause movement. These are found in limbs like the knee joint or the elbow joint or the shoulder joint. So all the limbs, because if you see our hands and legs, they are like most flexible. They result in a lot of movements. So they are all examples of synovial.
Thank you. please visit www.examfuel.com to watch more educational videos with a better experience. Please do not forget to like and subscribe to our YouTube channel for latest updates. Thank you once again.